Hey, how's it going? Alex here from IdeaSpot. Today we have a comparison between the Kadence theme and the Blocksy theme. So we're going to be comparing the free version of Blocksy to the free version of Kadence. I think these are two of the best free WordPress themes you can get, especially when you're building with Gutenberg. They make things much easier. So I'm going to be comparing across a few different categories. So make sure you watch this one right to the end. We're going to compare Blocksy and Kadence in four different categories. So the first comparison we'll make is the starter sites. Both Blocksy and Kadence offer some very nice starter sites. When you first install the theme, you can import a demo site, a starter site, and you can customize that to fit your own project. So both of them do a really good job there. We'll go through that in detail. The customizer, this is the highlight of both Blocksy and Kadence. Both of them have excellent, excellent customizers, very similar customizers as well. So we'll have a closer look at that. The block builder. So Blocksy comes with Kubely blocks and Kadence comes with Kadence blocks. So both of these block builders make building pages using Gutenberg much, much easier than using Gutenberg by itself. They have pre-designed blocks. They have additional blocks. They make building in Gutenberg much more simple than just using Gutenberg by itself, but you still get the benefit of the compatibility and speed of using Gutenberg in WordPress while making things easier with a customized block builder from the theme. So we'll look at that in more detail. And finally, there's speed and performance. Both of these are excellent in terms of their speed and performance, but we'll have a closer look in more detail about how these actually compare. So let's get going. Okay, first up, looking at the Blocksy starter sites. So we get six here. Now, these come for various page builders. So for example, business, you get them for Gutenberg, Brizzy, and Elementor, but product reviews is only an Elementor one. Modern shop is only for Brizzy and Elementor. App is Gutenberg and Brizzy, and so on. So I think for Gutenberg, my favorite ones were Blocksy News, which was for Gutenberg, and the business site, which was all for all three. So just make sure the page matches which one you want to build with. So I've been focusing on Gutenberg, and I'll focus on Gutenberg for this comparison. But it's important to realize that the only WooCommerce site they've got set up here is Modern Shop, and that's only Brizzy and Elementor. So cool if you're using those two, but for Gutenberg, they don't actually have a starter site for WooCommerce. But it is pretty easy to add WooCommerce to any of these, but it would have been nice to have a WooCommerce starter site for Blocksy for Gutenberg. So hopefully they add that soon, but that's just one point that would make me choose Kadence in this situation, because Kadence has a couple of WooCommerce starter sites already built. We'll get to those in a second. But as I was saying before, I really do like this business website for Blocksy. This is going to suit a lot of projects just because a lot of high ticket companies have this style of website. This is very on point for current design methodology. You've got your sticky header, transparent header. It all looks top notch. So I really did like this one. And I really do like this blog, the Blocksy News. This would be perfect for a tech blog, an affiliate blog. Any kind of industry or professional blog would look really quite good on this. And I think this would do really well. If you were looking at setting up a dedicated blog with Blocksy News, that would work very well. The shop itself is for Elementor and Brizzy, but it does look quite good. This is a very standard looking clean shop where you could customize this and get it to suit lots of different styles of shop. It's a very nice, simple template to work with for building a shop. But it would be nice if they built this for Gutenberg as well as Brizzy and Elementor. All right, let's move on to Kadence's starter site. So Kadence looks like it's got nine now for its Gutenberg starter sites. And if you can switch to Elementor in the top right there, and you'll see how many it's got for Elementor. So nine for Gutenberg, and currently there are five for Elementor. Now, all of these look really quite good as well. I think the Blocksy ones were a little bit more corporate, more professional. These pop a little bit more. These are a bit more interesting. They'll suit probably a few different kinds of more casual projects as well as professional projects. So my personal favorites are probably the agency one. This would suit lots of digital agency type projects. And the print shop is a very versatile WooCommerce store. This is for Gutenberg. And I believe it's for Elementor as well. Yes, Gutenberg and Elementor. So this is an excellent WooCommerce shop for either Gutenberg and Elementor. So this is the agency. I've used this plenty of times. This is a really nice, super fast loading, super clean looking professional agency for a digital agency, social media marketing. You could do web design. Anything in the tech sphere would look really nice on this starter site. And this WooCommerce store for Gutenberg and Elementor, this is good. I mean, you could sell pretty much anything you want. They've kept it very simple and clean looking, so you could adapt this. And this is going to convert really well. It's fast, it's simple, easy to use. So you just let your products do the talking, really, and this is going to work really well. Like I mentioned earlier, either Blocksy or Kadence, you can add WooCommerce to any of these templates. It's not really all that hard. The customizer comes with a WooCommerce section in there where you can set up your shop and your product pages. So I actually did a previous tutorial where I took this agency site and turned it into a WooCommerce site, and it was only like 10 minutes or 15 minutes to do that. And it's very nice. You can take any of these starter sites really for Blocksy or Kadence in Gutenberg and turn those into WooCommerce stores. So it's not a big deal, but I think when you're starting out, if you just want something that's good to go, this is a really nice choice. So kudos to Kadence for this really nice shop WooCommerce starter site. So I think on the starter sites, I'm going to give Kadence the edge here just by one point. They both have awesome starter sites. I think if you're using Gutenberg, these are some of the best around. There's just not that many at the moment, but I think in the future that will come. There'll be more starter sites to choose from. I gave Kadence the edge just because that shop is ready for Gutenberg. I think a lot of projects are going to want to use that, that print shop and the other store they have as well. They have two for Gutenberg. So I gave it the edge to Kadence, but both of these are top-notch in terms of their starter sites. All right, let's talk about the customizer. So Blocksy, we are in the Blocksy customizer here. We've got lots of great options for the header. We've got three section headers where you can put loads of things in the header. They can be sticky, they can be transparent, and you've got lots of options to work with in terms of their layouts and sticky functionality. Awesome. You've got options to look at your mobile header in more detail as well. Blocksy has handled the headers and footers excellently. Those are the main things to look at when you're looking at a WordPress customizer, are the headers and footers. The other things to look at are the blogs and the WooCommerce options as well. So both of these have really nailed these sections as well. So you've got lots of options for your blog posts, lots of options for the actual single post as well. And it's incredible, really. WooCommerce as well, you can do the same thing. So you can look at your product archives for the store. You've got different layouts for your store, title options. So lots of things you can do. It's very similar to Kadence. So I'm in the Kadence customizer now as well. You'll notice that it's quite similar. The header options have the same sort of three section layout. You can look at the mobile options as well. You can go back, similar options for the footer, and you've got similar design choices for your blog post. You've got your single post layout, and you've also got your actual blog archive layout as well. These are things that people tend to have trouble with when they're first building with a WordPress website, it's just setting up that actual blog layout. So I think Kadence and Blocksy do a great job of making that work really well. So this is the Kadence blog page that you'll get with this starter site, and I'll just load that up. So very clean looking, standard looking blog. It works straight out of the box. So lots of people can have a lot of good times with this Kadence blog. Same with the Blocksy blog. Now for WooCommerce, I don't have WooCommerce actually installed on this starter site, but I have done a complete tutorial on WooCommerce, and I really did enjoy integrating WooCommerce with these Kadence starter sites. So I think these customizers are so similar, it's hard to really split them. I think they're both probably the best free customizers I've seen. I think there's some pro customizers that have more stuff, but these are really easy to use. These are pretty much everything you need to do to get your project running with WordPress. So with these customizers, I don't think there's any choice. I have to give them both 10 out of 10. These are the best customizers that I've used in a free version of a theme in WordPress. Both of them are excellent. I really appreciate the work both of these guys have done. So 10 out of 10 for both Blocksy and Kadence. So now we're going to look at the block builder as well. So I'm in my homepage here on the Blocksy theme. I can go ahead and I can add in, say, a new block. And you'll see that we can have lots of different Kubli blocks, which they've integrated with the Blocksy theme. So lots of additional blocks for Gutenberg. And the really nice thing that they include is this layout importer. So when you're a beginner and you don't have much design experience in Gutenberg, you can just pull in some very nice pre-designed sections. You can just pop those into your page and they'll inherit the page's formatting already. So you get to keep the fonts and colors consistent with your theme without really doing any work. So for example, here I've just popped in a section from the Kubli page importer. So I've popped that section in there, and then it's just a matter of clicking and adjusting the background images and the text like I did in my previous tutorial. One small issue I did personally encounter was that when I go to preview and I try to preview the mobile version of this, all these blocks look a bit messed up. I'm not sure if this bug was something I've done or what's happening here, but it wasn't a big deal for me because I usually just go into Chrome and do the inspection and use the I use the mobile responsive tool in Chrome to look at it. And you can just preview in various popular devices, so iPhone X. Everything looked really good from the actual starter site, but when I started pulling in these Kubely blocks, sometimes I had to do a little bit of work to get these to look right. So for example, this one, the page breaks weren't done properly. I could easily fix that when I replaced the text with my own text, but just something to look out for, that these pre-designed sections in the Kubely blocks aren't always perfectly mobile designed. But the actual blocks that came from Blocksy itself, they all look really good straight out of the box. So maybe that's just something to do with Kubely and its integration. But I think that's not such of a big deal because this is how I work normally anyway. This mobile preview in Gutenberg hasn't been around that long, so may still be a few teething issues there. Let's move on to the Kadence block builder. So when we go to edit our page, we'll get our block builder loaded up with Gutenberg, and we can show the process of adding Kadence blocks. So I'll go ahead and add one before here. And the easiest way to do this is to add row layouts. And this will unlock this pre-built library of Kadence blocks. So these are really good. I think there's only 30, maybe slightly more than 30 of these, but these look really cool. I think they've got some cool illustrations on them sometimes. And the actual colors and layouts look really nice. And these are going to actually inherit colors and fonts and things, just the same as Blocksy as well. So it's very nice workflow when you're just pulling in these pre-designed elements to your website. And besides that, Kadence similarly gives you a range of blocks to include on your site as well. So you can go into your browser here and you've got Kadence blocks. So they've given you extra blocks, which makes using Gutenberg that much easier. And like I said before, by far the nicest one is that row layout that unlocks those pre-designed blocks. So when you're starting out, they've really got you covered. You'll make a lot of progress using these Kadence blocks. So like I said, they were very nice to use. Here's an example of one I've used, and the mobile preview is working really well in this one. So this is one of the blocks I just dropped in. It looks really good. You can edit it live. So I think the user experience for me was just a little bit nicer in Kadence. So I think the workflow was a bit better, and I spent a bit less time putting this starter site together compared to Blocksy. So I think Kadence has a slight edge in this case. So for the block builder, I'm going to give Kadence a 9 and Blocksy an 8. There was a little bit more work involved in getting the Blocksy site running compared to Kadence. I think Kadence was very seamless. I think Blocksy had like a lot more free blocks though, which was cool. So I think there was a bit more variety there. But the Kadence ones, even though there was only slightly more than 30, they were very nice. So both of them do really well in terms of making Gutenberg actually usable. I think without having a block builder included, building with Gutenberg is still not good enough. I think you need one of these block builders to make your life livable when you're trying to build with Gutenberg, especially when you're starting out. So in conclusion, both of these do a pretty good job. Kadence does slightly better. So 8 out of 10 and 9 out of 10. Now, in terms of speed and performance, I am just going to reference this excellent video that Jack Chow has put together on the comparison between Blocksy and Kadence. So that is over on the Jack Chow channel, another excellent small WordPress content creator on YouTube. I'll link to that video in the description. But big shout outs to Jack, and thanks for putting this work together. Excellent comparison in terms of their speed and performance. Now, basically, to summarize the performance comparison, they are both excellent. They both get an A in the Pingdom speed test, so 92 for both of them. Blocksy is slightly heavier, but only by about 70 kilobytes. It's not something that most people are going to notice at all. The load time itself was identical practically, just a few milliseconds difference. Blocksy does generate 3 more requests, so slightly higher load with Blocksy, but again, it's not a noticeable performance difference. For those of you obsessed with Google Page Speed Insights on mobile, both of them did pretty well. Kadence, again, slightly ahead. I think that's just due to being slightly lighter, maybe slightly more effective in terms of the way they've coded it. But if you want the full details, check out Jack's video because he goes very, very in depth in that area. So, but the conclusion is both of them are excellent. I think I would be happy using either of those for high performance. Occasionally, you might get someone who's obsessed with Google PageSpeed and really wants 90 plus. So you might want to go with Kadence and make that job a little bit easier. But You're not going to have any trouble at all ranking content with either of those themes. I wouldn't worry about speed. These are both top notch. I will just mention quickly that these speed tests will run on SiteGround hosting and just using a basic homepage. So fairly small, lightweight, like you can see, around 200 kilobytes of data. So pretty good little simple comparison. Both get an easy 10 out of 10. Most themes are nowhere near as fast as Blocksy or Kadence. So yeah, don't worry about speed. You're working with the best with either of these guys. So where does that leave us overall? I think Kadence wins by a hair. I mean, the workflow was a slightly more refined experience with Kadence, and there was a very, very slight performance bonus, but you can't miss with either of those. I think the actual decision is going to come down to if you're using one of those starter sites, which starter site do you like the look of? Which page builder are you going to be using? So that's probably going to decide it for me when I do a project. Sometimes I'm really going to like that Blocksy business site, or I'm really going to like that Blocksy news blog. Sometimes I'm really going to like that Kadence WooCommerce site. So I'll probably be using both of these throughout the next year, but again, totally up to you. You can't miss with either of those. I can recommend both of these very highly. All right, I'm going to put the complete tutorials for both of these themes right here, Kadence and Blocksy. Check those out. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.